today we're going to begin planning our clay projects. Remember, you can make anything that you'd like out of clay. It's your job to think like a sculptor and be creative. I'm going to give you a whole bunch of clay ideas, but you can come up with your own amazing idea too. You could simply push and pull something to make a letter, or something simple like a pendant, or something to hang from the wall, a keychain, or a mobile to hang in your room. You could even make something really unique and special, like an animal or something from a movie. You could also practice and explore some more advanced techniques like creating a pinch pot. You could simply make a pinch pot into a simple cup. Give it texture and color later, and that would be quite special to have at home. Or maybe you have a plan for your cup to be used for something else. Maybe you take this pinch pot and you turn it in a different direction so that it can look like a certain kind of animal. Or maybe you even practice your skill of rolling a coil. That has endless possibilities. You can also take your clay and draw into it, remember? Adding lots of textures and details with all the different tools. Did you know that you could even cut out part of the clay to make a donut or something unique? Right here is a loom. You could make this loom from clay and then weave in it later. You can also make multiple pieces out of the clay you will be given, like a lid or multiple pinch pots to make a wind chime or a bell. You can also practice your skill of making a slab. Simple slabs like tiles or something with your name in it or turning it into an animal would be really fun, but you can even go more complex with your slab building. You can add to your slab building and you can cut it away, so maybe it's a frame or something like that. Now remember, if you'd like to add something to your clay, you need to follow those four S's: score, slip, stick, and smooth. The rest of these ideas require you to use those four S's because clay has been added on top. You can simply add stuff on top, like this tile, or you can fold clay in half to make a rattle by putting something inside of it so it would be a musical instrument. You could make something out of it, like this pocket to hang on the wall or a flower, by simply adding clay. The possibilities are endless. Did you know that your clay could just be a beautiful sculpture to look at? Or your clay could be something useful and practical for you at home or at school. You can even have fun with it if you have a creative idea. You could make an animal or a totem pole or something silly. Remember, your own idea is amazing too.
So whatever idea you choose, you need to complete the ceramic planning form. First, of course, write your name on it and your class code. In the big square, you have a job. Your job is to draw your idea out. Fill it with as many details so you are sure to go into making it with a plan. After you've drawn it out, then go back and circle all of the different techniques that you are going to use. That way you've really thought through the process of how to make your clay project.